So the idea of the muddiest point, if you're not familiar with that, that particular technique, it's at the end of a class. I mean, it doesn't have to be at the end of the class. It could be anytime during class, but you ask students to just spend a few minutes writing down what was a confusing aspect of today's class. That's the idea of the muddiest point. It's not really clear. It's kind of, the concept is still a little muddy. And so that's something that you would often do during the learning process while you're still teaching concepts and skills so that you could get some feedback about where students are struggling. And so that's going to happen during learning. So it's formative assessment. It's low stakes. You probably wouldn't make that a major component of a grade or a student's performance. So it's probably low stakes or no stakes. And it's indirect in that you're not actually measuring that particular muddy point exactly. You're asking for students' perceptions about what they think about that. So that would be an example of that muddiest point assessment activity, because it is an assessment activity. Is an example of a formative, low stakes or no stakes, and an indirect type of assessment. If you were to do some sort of indirect approach to assessment, like a muddiest point activity, and you see that students seem to like generally just focus on this one concept or this one skill where they're still really unclear. That's really important for you to pay attention to that, because that students are signaling to you that they are struggling with a particular concept. And that's really valuable information, particularly when you think about assessment as a tool for learning improvement.